Scarcely fit company, my daughter, for you.
Now all I do, though most we good company, we're scarcely fit company for a lady like you.
Proud officer, that haughty lip on call, vain man suppress that supercilious sneer, for I have dared to love your matchless girl, a fact well known to all my messmates here.
Oh, horror!
My distress, I find it is not easy to
my amazement, my surprise, you may learn from the expression of my eyes. My lord, one word, the facts are not before you. The word was injudicious, I allow. But hear my explanation, I implore you, and you will be indignant too, I vow. I will hear of no defense. Attempt not if you're sensible. That word of evil sense is wholly indefensible. Go, ribald, get you hence to your cabin with celerity.
Oh, that's me!
This is the consequence of ill-advised asperity.
This is the consequence of ill-advised asperity.
For I'll teach you all ere long to refrain from language strong, for I have a deadly sympathy for ill-bred taunts.
No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts.
No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts. No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts. His sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts.